In this video, we will learn the basics of analyzing, visualizing, and mapping data in Solstice. So, we will learn how to use the Survey Visualization tab, which provides automatic, quick and simple visualizations. We will learn how to use the Survey Report, which gives you more room to customize at the individual survey level. And finally, we will look at building our own dashboard, including a map widget. Let's begin by going to our survey that we've collected data for, and here we can jump to the Visualization tab. This tab automatically generates visual widgets on the basis of the questions and the data in your survey, setting a filter for only responses that have been set to be final. Here we see, first of all, when the submissions for this response and survey have been made. Then we see a donut chart showing the responses for the survey. In this case, two communities declared ODF and one community not. Another calendar widget for the declaration dates, exactly as we had in our survey design. And finally, even an automatic map pointing the communities out. This is a very powerful, automatic, quick and simple tool where we can also split the view into two if we want to compare our data across two dimensions and then add filters. I'll quickly demonstrate that. Let's say on the left side we want to see all the communities that are ODF and on the right side the communities that are not ODF. The same kind of logic can apply to any of the questions in your survey. So I will add a filter. This opens a screen that allows me to explore the structure of my survey. I will choose the appropriate question and say, on the left side, only show me the responses where this question has been answered with a yes. Similarly, on the right side, I will select the same question, but filter it down to only the responses where it's been answered no. So now I see two answers have been answered yes, one answer has been answered no. These are the dates. And here are the locations. I can see that the yes communities are here, whereas the no community is over there. And remember, this same logic of split view in the visualization tab can be used for any dimension of your data. But this is automatically created. I can't really edit these widgets very well. That's what the survey report is for. So let me add this community declaration widget, as well as the map to the survey report. I see that these have been added, and if I now go to the survey report, I now see both of these. I can now start editing this in more detail. If I start editing the survey report, I get a palette of options on the left side. These widgets work by dragging and dropping. Let's say I want to give my report a title. I just drag the widget in and type in the title. I can add text and I can add further widgets. I can resize what I see and I can also drag and drop, move them around. Let's put these side by side. Remove this one. Now on the left side we have a map widget that shows all the sites, and on the right side, community widget, donut chart that shows the answers to the question, has the community been declared ODF? What's also great about these survey report is that these widgets are interactive. So if I only want to look at the no, I can click this donut chart and activate a filter, and then this map correspondingly also updates. I can remove the filter from here. If I want more information, I can click the map and then view the response right here. This is perfect, but this is only visible within this survey. Oftentimes, it can be useful to turn a survey report into a dashboard. Dashboards in Solstice are individual pages where you can combine as many widgets as you like from as many data sources as you like to create a story that is impactful and communicates what you want to communicate. You can then also share that dashboard with users of the system or even people who don't have a login to Solstice using the share link. Maps are also visualizations in Solstice where you have a whole page size map. Consoles are a combination of maps and dashboards and also data grids, which are our spreadsheet-like Excel-style tables. If I make this report into a dashboard, I'm taken to the Dashboards tab, and I see a largely similar platform. Port of the ODF Community Survey, and I'm going to start editing the widgets to be more informative. Let's make this map show whether or not a community has been declared ODF. I'll click the cogwheel on the top right and choose to edit it. I see that there is one layer on this map already, which is the layer of communities. I will customize this and get presented a fairly complicated view that's already been filled in with the right data source of our survey, the location, so where does the point show up on the map, which is the location of that community. But I want to color the point on the basis of data. So therefore, I select the question, has the community been declared ODF? Now, let's color that more correspondingly. So if it has, it's green. If it has not, let's choose orange. We can also make further adjustments to the layer, for example, by having a different kind of view. Let's say an asterisk for a community and make it extra large. Adjust community opacity and so on. Now I can immediately see on the map where are the sites that fit the ODF declaration and where the ODF declaration hasn't been done. Let's make this widget also corresponding color-wise, so we can change similarly yes to green and no to orange. And maybe I want to change it. Instead of a donut chart, I would just prefer a simple bar chart. Horizontal, I'll choose the vertical axis as has it been declared. So that's a different view of the same data. And we can also keep adding more and more widgets to our dashboard to make it more useful. Let's say I want to show my data in tabular format. I can just drag a table widget in, and then start filling it through. Every widget needs a data source, and now I can start filling in columns from there. So let's say from response metadata, I will see which user was it that submitted this data, when did they do it, so submitted on date, what did they say about the community declaration, and what community name did they submit the data for, and finally, what is the location? I'll find it here. Of that site. Now I can order it, I can filter all of this very powerfully. So now we have a table of our data in addition to our widgets. There's a number of options I finally want to cover in this video. One very powerful option is to set quick filters from the settings tab, which then become drop-downs that the user can choose. For example, if you wanted to select by community name, you can create a filter for that. Or you can create a quick filter to filter by ODF status. This all depends on the questions that you have asked in your survey. And can be very, very flexibly used. Finally, if I wanted to share this data with others, I can add other users of the system as viewers of my visualization, or I can even create a shareable link, which I can then share with people. They don't even need to have logins to the system. So now we've covered the basics of how to visualize data using survey visualization, including the split view, how to build a survey report at the survey level, and how to build a freestanding dashboard that can have data from one or more sources and can be easily shared. There's a lot more to learn about visualizations and analyses, and you can use the resource center available through the help icon to learn more. Or you can talk to us at info@solstice.world to perhaps arrange training or discuss any issues and questions you might have. Okay.